So, I mean, Payton makes some good passes, and there's just some big shots, shots that we needed. And then, like I said, Russ just gets his hands in there and picks the pressure and gets turnovers and steals.
Do you think that they were worn down late? They turned the ball over an awful lot.
Definitely, they got tired of not breaking the presses easily. Short on 1-on-1, missed free throws. Just kind of tired and just kind of little slower, and that just gives us an edge.
What about Gorgeous play? Not only tonight. It seems like he's getting better every
game. Oh, definitely. I mean, he's stepping into a role this year that we desperately need with TJ leaving. So he's a lot more confident. He's a lot more just, I guess, just comfortable playing his role and just rebounding and going offensive glass, blocking shots, and just playing his game.
There were a couple times when their guys looked like they had wide open layups, and he came from the other side and out of nowhere almost to block.
Oh, man, that's something that he's improved on a lot from last year, not goaltending, blocking at the right time, come from help side to make a great play and great stop.
You were talking about playing inside last year. How hard is it to switch late in a game like that where all of a sudden you're playing a different role?
I mean, it's a little more difficult, but it's kind of, I mean, when we're playing man, it's the same. We're all helping each other on dual penetration. The only difference is, I mean, I'm guarding a bigger man and I'm up on the ball in the press. But other than that, just stay in the middle of the high post against the zone and rebound.
Kyle, Rick was talking about how tired you guys were. I mean, how hard is it to play that speed, that full court press? It looks like when we're watching, like, oh, it's working. But yeah. Man, that's got to be exhausting, right?
Oh, it's very exhausting. I mean, we're breathing that heavy, we're exhausted. And we go against this every day in practice, and we put pressure on the other teams, and that's not something they go against. So that's where we get our competitive edge from. We wear them out, and at the end of games, they miss free throws, 1-on-1s, and just open layups, and we capitalize on it.
Kyle, how do games like this, you have Western coming up, how do games like this, these close games, prepare you for the Big East coming up, especially with Georgetown next week?
Right, I mean, this game gave us a couple lessons, like the last couple. We're still getting way too many threes, way too many open shots. We're not playing the aggressive defense that we need to, that we did early in the year. And then, I mean, as far as coming from behind, we're not comfortable with it. I mean, we'd rather be up, obviously, but we're so used to being behind in a couple games that we don't get rattled, we stay calm, we stick to our game plan and come out with a big win.
At the end of games, how do you stay calm and what's going through your hands? You know, how do you stay composed?
Well, I mean, like last year, we came from behind a lot. We have most of the guys back, minus a couple. So guys that are coming in, stepping into those roles, just kind of look up to Payton, look up to Chris or whoever. And coach is always talking about, okay, there's a lot of time left. We'll still come back. We'll get a stop here, get an easy layup down there, and then all of a sudden the game's cut. So we just stick together like that, get stops, and it all starts on the defensive end.
Kyle, I know it's a little off subject a little bit, but we got a Christmas special coming up.